Permanent mandibular second molar is the seventh tooth from the midline. Its tooth number in FDI system is 3, 7 and 4, 7. In universal system, 18 and 31. And in Zsigmondy-Palmer system, it is 7 with appropriate quadrant brackets. It develops from 4 developmental lobes. Mesiobuccal, distobuccal, mesiolingual and distolingual, which give rise to 4 cusps respectively. It has 2 roots, mesial root and distal root. Its function is grinding. In chronology, the tooth erupts at the age of 11 to 13 years. Due to this, it is sometimes also called as the 12-year molar. Coming to its dimensions, the cervico-occlusal length of the crown is 7 mm and the length of both roots is 13 mm. The mesiodistal diameter of the crown is 10.5 mm and at cervix it is 8 mm. The buccolingual diameter of the crown is 10 mm and at cervix it is 9 mm. The curvature of cervical line on mesial side is 1 mm and on distal side it is flat. The morphology of a tooth is studied under 5 aspects. Let us start with the buccal aspect. The outline form of the crown is trapezoidal in shape. Both buccal cusps are seen in front, mesiobuccal cusp and distobuccal cusp, which are almost equal in size. Both lingual cusps, mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp, are also seen partially. Both contact areas, mesial contact area and distal contact area, are in the middle third. Both outlines, mesial outline and distal outline, are convex. However, the cervical line is irregular. A buccal developmental groove is seen running between the two buccal cusps. A faint cervical ridge runs mesiodistally in the cervical third. From this aspect, both roots are visible. The root trunk is seen bifurcating into the mesial root and distal root. Both roots are almost parallel to each other with a distal tilt. Next, the lingual aspect. All the features of the outline form from the lingual aspect are same as that in the buccal aspect. Moreover, both lingual cusps are seen, mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp, and both are of equal size. A lingual developmental groove is seen running between the lingual cusps. Next, the mesial aspect. The outline form of the crown is rhomboidal in shape. Both mesial cusps are seen, mesiobuccal cusp and mesiolingual cusp. Both buccal and lingual outlines are convex, with crest of curvature of lingual outline in the middle third and buccal outline in the cervical third because of the cervical ridge. The cervical line is irregular. The mesial marginal ridge runs horizontally between the mesial cusps. Coming to the root, the mesial root is seen in front, which is conical in shape and has a developmental depression. Distal root is seen partially. Next, the distal aspect. The features of the outline form from the distal aspect are same as that from the mesial aspect. However, the distal marginal ridge is lower than the mesial marginal ridge, because of which more of occlusal surface is visible. From the distal aspect, the distal root is seen in front, which is conical in shape and has a developmental depression. Mesial root is seen partially. Finally, the occlusal aspect. The outline form of the crown is roughly rectangular in shape. 4 cusps are seen. Mesiobuccal cusp, distobuccal cusp, mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp. They are all of almost the same size. Ridges. Each cusp has 2 cuspal ridges. 1 mesial cuspal ridge and 1 distal cuspal ridge. 4 triangular ridges, one running from each cusp tip towards the center. 2 marginal ridges, mesial marginal ridge on the mesial border and distal marginal ridge on the distal border. Fossa. One central fossa, almost circular in shape, in the center of the occlusal surface. Mesial triangular fossa next to the mesial marginal ridge and distal triangular fossa adjacent the distal marginal ridge. Pits. There is a central pit in the central fossa, a mesial pit in the mesial triangular fossa and distal pit in the distal triangular fossa. Grooves. The central developmental groove extends from the mesial pit, runs through the central pit and ends in the distal pit. The buccal developmental groove runs from the central pit between the two buccal cusps onto the buccal surface. And the lingual developmental groove runs from the central pit between the lingual cusps onto the lingual surface. These three grooves make a cross pattern dividing the occlusal surface into four almost equal parts. Also, numerous supplementary grooves are present. In clinical considerations, fixed orthodontic treatment is usually done after the age of 13 years, that is, after the eruption of the second molars.